Next, we have to discuss about the system testing. Last class, we discussed about the integration testing, and before that, we are taking the unit testing, and likewise, we are going. And next, we have to test. Next testing process is the system testing. Okay. Then, the system testing. System testing is basically a black box testing technique conducted on complete integrated system to evaluate the system's compliance with its specified requirements. It is a testing for the system compliance with the specified requirements. Okay, and system testing takes as it input all of the integrated components that have passed integration testing. After completing the integration testing, we are moved into the system testing, and the input for the system testing is the output of the integration testing. The purpose of integration testing is to detect any inconsistencies between the unit that are integrated together. In the case of unit testing, it tested individually every units and every statements, and everything is tested in the unit testing. After that, we moved into the integration testing. In the integration testing, they are combined. A group of modules are checked. How the communication between the modules are checked in the case of integration testing. After that, we moved into the system testing. Okay, system testing seeks to detect defects both within the inner assemblance and along with the system as a whole. And system testing is performed on the entire system in the context of either functional requirement specification, FRS, functional requirement specification, and the system requirement specification, SRS, or both. All these cases are tested in the system testing. System testing, not only the design, but also the behavior and even the believed expansions of the customers. Okay, system testing includes the testing of fully integrated software system. Okay, generally a computer system is made with integrations of software. Any software is only a single element of a computer system. The software is developed in unit and then interfaced with other software and the hardware to create a complete computer system. Okay, then we already says that this integration testing is done with the group of modules, and group of modules are integrated modules are tested in the case of integration testing. After the integration testing, we moved into the system testing. In system testing, it tested the functional requirement specification and the system requirement specification and the designs, and everything is tested in the case of system testing. Okay, then here the to check the end-to-end flow of an application software is known as system testing. Okay, then in this we navigate or go through all the necessary modules and the application and check. Here it's showing the figures of the software testing. Here each and every modules and the flow of module data flow is tested by using the software testing. Okay, then there are four levels of software testing is there: unit testing, integration, acceptance testing, and we already take the class of unit testing and the integration testing. Okay, next we have to move into the software testing, and the software testing is mainly focused, or the techniques used for the software testing is both the white box testing and the black box testing. Then system testing falls, first of all we have to discuss about the system testing falls under the black box testing. Okay, the testing the external working of the software. Okay, system testing includes the following steps: the verification of input functions of the application to test whether it is producing the expected output or not. The way it is verifying whether it produced the expected output or if there are any problem to produce the output, all this checked by the system testing. And the testing of integrated software by including the external peripherals to check the interactions of various components with each other. That means the hardware components also checked by using the system testing. There are a lot of system testing is there. It's more than 50 types of system testing is there. We have the most of the companies are typically use some of them. We have to list some of them. That is regression testing, load testing, functional testing, recovery, migration, usability, software and hardware testing, performance testing, stress testing, deployment testing, and likewise a lot of system testing is there. We have to check with some of them. Okay, first of all, the regression testing. Regression testing involves testing done to make sure none of the changes made over the course of the development process have caused new bugs. There is any more, if we make any modification, that modification fails any bugs. That is checked by using the regression testing. Regression testing is performed under system testing to confirm, identify that there is any defects in the system due to modification. Due to modification is the detect or feel any bugs, that is checked by using the regression testing. At the time of modification, it makes sure any changes done during the development process have not introduced a new defects, and also have gives assurance old defects will not exist on the additions of the new software over the time. Then if we are adding in anything new into that software, and based on that new modification, based on this additional addition added to the software, there is no bugs is checked by using the regression testing. Next we have to test with the load testing, and the load testing is necessary to know that a software solution will perform under real life loads. It is checked the real workload of the real time loads or not. It is checked by the load testing. And in the functional testing, function testing involves trying to think of any possible missing function. Any possible missing functions is tested by using the functional testing, and the tester makes a list of vital function that should be in system and can be added during the functional testing and should improve the quality of the software. Okay, the testers might take a list of additional functionalities. What all are the additional functionalities we need? That make a list by using the tester that a product could have improve it during the functional testing. What all are the things we need to added, and what all are the things we need to avoid in the software, that is listed by using the tester. And these changes, and what the changes if we want to add or if we want to remove, all this done at the time of functional testing. This is functional testing. And next we have to go to recovery testing. Then the recovery testing is done to demonstrate a software solution is reliable, trustworthy, and can be successfully recovered from possible crashes. This is checked by using the recovery testing, and this is mainly used to confirm the reliability and trust of the software, accountability and accountability of the system, and all are lying on the recovering skills of the system. And if we want to recover all the possible system crashes successfully in the case of the recovery testing. In the testing, we will test the application to check how well
it recover the crashes or disasters. And recovery testers testing contains the following steps. And whenever the software crashes, it should not vanish, but should write the crash log message or error log message. And if we feel any crashes, if we feel any bugs, it gives a message, and based on that message, it goes to the further processing. This is happens in the case of recovery testing. Next. Migration testing. In migration testing is done to ensure that the software can be moved from older system infrastructure to current system infrastructure without any issues. That is checked by using the migration testing. And the usability testing mainly focused on the user's ease to use, user's easiness and user friendliness to use the application, flexibility in handling controls, and the ability of the system to meet its objectives. This is done in the case of the usability. How the user is familiar with that application is checked by using the usability checking. And next we have to take the security testing. Then in the security testing, the computer-based system that manages sensitive information or causes action that can improperly harm or benefit individually in a target for improper or illegal penetration. The penetration spans a broad range of activities. Hackers who attempt to penetrate the system for sport, and dissatisfied employees who attempt to penetrate for revenge, and dishonest individuals who attempt to penetrate for illicit personal gains. And likewise, the security the data security and the information security is done by using the security testing. Next we have the stress testing. The stress test are designed to confirm the programs with the abnormal situation. Stress testing executes a system in a manner that demands the resources in abnormal quantity, frequency or volume. Okay, these all are the check by using the stress testing. Okay, the recovery of the system from such phase after the stress is detected by this stages. And next we have the performance testing. In the performance testing is designed to test the runtime performance of a software. The runtimes at the time of running, how it is performed, that is checked by the performance testing. And the performance testing can occur through all the steps in the testing process, even at the unit levels. The performance of an individual modules may be accessed or test as conducted. However, it is not until all the elements are fully integrated that the true performance of the system can be ascertained. Okay, this there are different techniques we have in the case of the performance testing. That is by using the load test, stress test, and this SOC test and the spike test. These all are the different testing for the performance testing. Okay, we already seen the load test and the stress test. Load and stress test we already seen, and the SOC test is known as the endurance testing, is performed to determine the system parameters under continuous expected loads. And in case of the spike, increasing the number of users suddenly by a very large amount and measuring the performance of the system. The main aim is to determine whether the system will be able to sustain the workload. It is used to sustain the workload is done by using the stress spike test. And then not only this type of testing process, behalf of that, the having the deployment testing is there, hardware software testing is there. The deployment testing is done at the time of the deployment or delivery processing, and the hardware software testing also done by using the system testing.
And why we are using this system testing is to reduce all the bugs, mitigating live issues and the bugs even after the productions are done by using the system testing. Okay, then next we have to discuss on the next video. Thank you.